Assumptions are something taken for granted. That is a fact that is accepted to be true, considering the contents of the given statement. In this section, you will see a statement followed by two assumptions. You need to assess the statement, then decide which of the given assumptions is implicit or the one that is taken for granted, and then accordingly mark the options. Assumptions. To solve these questions, here is the first quick tip. Assumptions should be drawn only from the given statement, not from your real life experiences. To understand this, here is an example. Statement: please put more people on the job to make up for the delay. So here the core idea is there is a delay and they're thinking of putting more people. And here are the assumptions. Delay is inevitable in most jobs. The second one, output will increase with more number of people on the job. Now analyze both of these assumptions. First, think about the delay. Delay is inevitable in most jobs. What do you think? If you look at our personal experiences, we know there could be a delay, but we cannot write off that there will be delay in every job. So therefore, this is not strong. This is actually weak. So we cannot go by this assumption. Now coming to the second assumption, output will increase with more number of people on the job. Now, can this assumption lead to this particular statement? Yes, because they believed that if we take more people, the job could be done easily and the output would increase. Based on this assumption, probably the management have taken the decision that more people have to be taken in order to reduce the delay. Therefore, this is the right answer. The second tip, don't extrapolate beyond what is given in the statement to arrive at false assumptions. Here we have the statement. Everybody loves reading adventure stories. Assumptions. Adventure stories are the only reading material. Look at this term, only. The second one, nobody loves reading any other material. So any other. If you analyze the first assumption says that adventure stories are the only reading material. Now, in order to get to this statement, probably we might assume that they are the only material, maybe because of that they have taken this decision. But we cannot directly assume that this is the only thing, because there could be books which are of different stories other than adventure. So this is not strong, this is actually weak. So we cannot go by our personal real life experiences. In the second assumption, we cannot claim that nobody loves reading any other material. This also we cannot assume directly. So even this is weak. So personal assumptions has to be excluded. Here's a third quick tip. If a notice is put up, the implicit assumption is the one which will have impact. What we mean by this is, if there's a notice, then look for the one which will give an impact. That will be the implicit assumption. So here is an example. Statement: do not copy our software without our permission. A notice. Assumptions: it is possible to copy the software. Such warning will have some effect. Now look at the first assumption. It is possible to copy the software. And it's pretty obvious, because the software is able to be copied, that is the reason why there was a notice, and the notice says that don't copy the software. So this is strong. We can take it as valid assumption. The second one, such warning will have some effect. Again, this is also strong and we can take it as valid, because if they believe that there is an effect, then only they'll give out a notice. Therefore, even this is right.
This is an easy topic. Just solve sufficient questions to get grip on the topic. All the best.